Stephen Gostkowski. Gostkowski's kick is up, and his kick is good for the lead. Snap, set, kick, good! Stevie G puts it through for 51. On the way, good! Gostkowski bombs it home. Gostkowski's kick is up. Good! Good!
Stephen, I want to ask you to begin with, if everything we heard in the offseason was true, and that is your interest in playing for the Titans was predicated by a move of your family to Middle Tennessee. Do I have that right?
Yeah, I mean, that's part of the story. I mean, my wife's from Memphis, and I went to school in Memphis, obviously, and when my time with the Patriots was up, you know, we decided that, you know, the greater Nashville area was going to be where we were going to go. And I was lucky enough to have an opportunity to try out for the Titans. Seemed like a good coincidence not to turn down.
After a wildly successful career, how hard was an off season of so many things being up in the air about what came next for you?
I mean, I'm not going to say that it was hard. I mean, it's obvious there's a lot of uncertainty. You know, anytime you get to play for a long time in the NFL, you know, you got to consider yourself blessed. I was lucky enough to get 14 years in up in New England, and you play this long, it's icing on the cake on top of it. It's a tough business to be in because it doesn't last very long, and there's a lot of uncertainties, and you know, you're always a couple games or an injury away from never playing again. And I think the hardest thing was just rehabbing my surgery I had last year kind of on my own, you know, doing Peloton workouts and, you know, watching YouTube videos and working out on my own. So I think that was the hardest thing. And, you know, then only having 1 week of practice before the first game was odd. But I think everything about this year has been odd and just kind of have to roll with the punches. You know, things don't always go your way right away. You just have to keep your head up and persevere and, you know, move on and try to help your team win.
Tell us about your family. What about your children?
Yeah, so I have three kids. I got two boys and a girl. I got a 10-year-old, a 7-year-old, and a 4-year-old, Slade and Gannon and Lila. And, you know, they've become great, great big Titans fans now, so it's pretty cool.
I think I've seen them in the stands already, haven't I?
I'm sure if you saw the only two boys with number three jerseys dancing around, that's probably them.
How has that changed your perspective about your job as an NFL player, having children who are now old enough to really know what's going on in your life?
It's cool. I mean, you know, it's pretty funny, but it, you know, I guess some of your words come back to bite you in the butt. You know, I missed a kick the other day and my son comes home and he tells me I need to practice some more. So you got some stuff like that going on. It's kind of hard to argue with him because every time he does something wrong in his sports, I tell him we need to do more practice. So I guess you learn a little bit from your kids. And, you know, I've been very fortunate and blessed. I mean, my oldest son has been to five Super Bowls, which, you know, is crazy to think about. And it's kind of cool, you know, but at the same time, I don't think they realize how lucky they are being able to experience going to NFL games all the time and playoff games and Super Bowl parades and stuff like that. And hopefully, you know, one day they'll really get to appreciate it.
Would you have thought 20 years ago that you'd be pitching in the big leagues or kicking in the NFL?
Well, I mean, my whole life I wanted to play baseball, but, you know, my kick stopped curving and my curveball started going a little bit straighter, and that kind of made the decision for me.
Well, you've had a lot more success than failure in your career. And for Titans fans, we think about the 55-yarder at Minnesota to win the ball game. I mean, it's a long kick to start with, and it was your sixth kick of the day. So when you're going onto the field at that point, I'm dying to know, what's your mindset at that moment?
Well, a day like that where, you know, you've already made a ton of kicks, you know, that's when it becomes kind of easy because you're just in the zone and in rhythm and you feel really good. And you live for moments like that because those are the moments that you can show that, you know, what you got mentally, and then you can really prove yourself to a team. You know, I think to me, the most important kicks happen at the end of the game. And, you know, those are the only opportunities where you can really show a little bit of toughness at our position. It makes you feel alive, makes you feel like you're really part of the game, and was thankful for that opportunity.
We're thankful you're here, and we hope that your son, your oldest son, can go to his sixth Super Bowl come February.
Amen.